So I have this rather unusual setup, although I think it's going to become much more common, where I have camera angles that I only want to use the video from, and I have audio angles where I only want to use the audio. This particular example is where we have three people at lunch, Craig and I and Serena, where we only want to use the video from angle one or two, but we'll never want to use the audio from there, and we want to use audio only from three, four, or five, depending on who's speaking. I've got sick of changing the mode every time I wanted to make an edit, so I decided to take it into my own hands, and with help from Gregory Clark, who developed the AppleScript, we've set up services so that Final Cut Pro services now include switch to video one, switch to video two, switch to audio three, four, and five, by including the command to go to the type of edit that you want to make, and then the command to make the edit. And these are assigned to my functions keys one through five, which have been assigned away from their default functions. So how is this done? Well, first of all, we need to set up some services in Automator. So I'm going to swap across to Automator. When you run Automator, you can create a new. We then have to choose the type of document, and we want a service. So we're going to create a new service. No input, because this is just going to drive functions. So we'll get down to no input. We only want it to work in Final Cut Pro 10, which is not one of the defaults. So hit F on the keyboard, and it will go to that area of the list and choose Final Cut Pro 10. And we want to run an AppleScript. That's all of this service is going to do, is run an AppleScript. So a utility Run Applescript. I'm just going to drag that into there. We do need to add in the AppleScript, and this is some magic that Greg created for me. It tells system events to tell Final Cut Pro 10 do a keystroke number 2 using option down and shift down. Option down shift down 2 changes to video only switching. Option shift 3 changes to audio only switching. And then we just send a straight 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to change the angle. So the first act part is telling it to make it the right type of edit, and the second part is choosing what angle is going to be taken. That's all we need to do. We need to save that as switch to video 2 service. I just want to identify it from what my current services are so that I will not screw them up. We repeat that for 2, 3, 4, or 5. That's the other angles and the other type of edit. So eventually we'll end up with the five types of edit, but we really need to assign those keystrokes. And this is where system preferences comes in. It's in the keyboard area, shortcuts in the keyboard, and our services appear here automatically when we select services. They will appear, and there's the service we just created. You can create a shortcut, just double click in there and then press the keystroke that you want. So if I want that to be video of F6, for example, I simply press F6 and that becomes the shortcut. I tried reassigning keystrokes away from current defaults in Final Cut so that I could use them to trigger these, and I found that although you can customize the keyboard, when it comes to sending keystrokes to the event via AppleScript, only the default keyboard is supported. So in order to get the functions to not do the things that the functions normally do, a little utility was required, and it's called Function Flip. It's free from Kevin Gessner, and we want Function Flip to be on all the time, but the default swapped around. You still have brightness up, brightness down, expose A, and launchpad, but now to get those, you press the function key to the bottom left of the keyboard and then press the actual function key that you want. Back in Final Cut Pro 10, I can use the function keys to switch both mode and angle at the same time. I found on an earlier version that I would have to run it first with using the menu, but On this system, it seems to work fine the first time without using the menu the first time. That was a laptop. This is an iMac. So all I need to do to switch, say, between video angle 1 and video angle 2 is hit function 2, and it changes to video only mode and then audio mode. If I go to hit F4, we've changed to audio mode and switched to audio 4. Similarly, audio 5 on F5, back to audio 3. We can switch to video angle 1 as well. It's that simple, and it all relies on the magic of Automator running an Applescript feeding into the text input to Final Cut Pro 10. But it's made my editing of these multicams so much faster. I never want to use the audio from the video angles, and there is no video for the audio only angles. So this is a great solution if you find yourself in a similar position. Feel free to use the Applescript. It comes with our compliments.